गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन अवर मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड फिफ्थ लेसन फ्रैक्शंस एंड वी कम टू नो व्हाट इज द मीन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन। लेट्स रिकॉल इट, व्हाट इज द फ्रैक्शन? अ पार्ट ऑफ द होल। व्हेनेवर वी आर काउंटिंग एनी अदर थिंग एंड दैट शुड बी लेस ऑफ वन, लेस देन वन, दैट टाइम वी आर यूजिंग द फ्रैक्शन टू शो दैट पार्ट ऑफ दैट थिंग्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट that is the next one, comparison of fractions. Whenever we have the two fractions, so how we are going to do the comparison between these two fractions, which one is the greater and which one is the smaller, or we can say the both should be equal. So let's learn in detail comparing like fractions. Whenever we are having the like fraction, what do you mean by the like fraction? Like fraction means the fractions which have the equal denominator. The fraction which have equal denominator is called like fraction. So if we have such kinds of fraction, for that here we have example. Here we have a strip and that is divided into four equal parts. Now colored part is equal to, what is the colored part? If you are able to see, that is 1 and 1, 2, 3, 4, total is 4, means we can say colored part is 1 upon 4 and the second is uncolored. Part is equal to, if we are talking about the uncolored part, so 1, 2, 3, how many parts are uncolored? That is 3 and total is 4. So in these two, if you are able to see, we have the same denominator, and if we have the same denominator, that means these two are the like fractions. Now forget this all and come to know, here we have the two parts, colored and uncolored, which one is the greater? Which one is the greater? If you are able to see, so we can say the uncolored part should be greater than the colored part. So we come to know that is 1 upon 4 is less than 3 upon 4. Is it? Yes. Means we come to know for the conclusion, if we have the equal denominator, means like fraction, and in that case, if we want to do the comparison between these two fractions, if those numerator is greater, that should be the greater fraction. Yes, here 4, 4 are equal, and here we have the numerator 1 and here we have the numerator 3. 3 is greater than 1, so we can say 3 upon 4 is greater than 1 upon 4. Got it? Once again, if we have the like fraction, means denominator should be same, we want to decide which one is greater. And that should be depend on the numerator. Which numerator should be greater? The whole fraction is greater. Like in our diagram, we can see. Come for the second comparison. Comparing the fractions with the equal numerators. Earlier we learned about the like fractions. Like fractions means the equal denominator. But second type of the comparison is equal numerator. See, here we have the two strips of the same size. If you are able to see, these two strips are the same size. And strip A divided into two equal parts and strip B divided into three equal parts. So now, in the first strip, what is the colored part? Colored part is equal to, what is that? 1 upon 2. 1 is colored and total 2 parts are there. So we can say 1 upon 2. And colored part in B strip is equal to, here also we have 1 part colored, but here we have 1, 2, 3. Total how many parts we have? 3. So out of these 2, just we have written colored part in both the strips. Just forget it for a minute and see. You are able to see which one is the greater colored part. So you are able to see in the A strip that is the first one is greater than this one. This one means 1 upon 2 is greater than 1 upon 3. 1 upon 2 is greater than 1 upon 3. That means we can say if we are deciding by the denominator. If you are able to see here, we have the equal numerator. Now we have to decide on the basis of denominator. So if you are going to decide with the base, with the denominator, so we can come to know the smaller denominator is the greater one. Here we have the denominator 3 and here we have the denominator 2. But then also 1 upon 2 is greater than 3. Got it? As because that we come to know according to this diagram. So whenever we have the equal numerator, in that case the smaller denominator will become the greater fraction. Now come for the third type of the comparison, that is comparing unlike fractions. Unlike fractions means the fraction those who do not have the equal denominator, or we can say different denominator. So the most important thing is given. First, convert the unlike fractions into like fractions. See, for example, here we have 5 upon 3 and second 2 upon 4. These two fractions are unlike fractions. And here the numerator also different and the denominator is also different. Now there is only one way to do the comparison between these two fractions. That is, we have to convert these fractions into like fractions. As we learn, multiple of 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 and so on. Multiple of 4, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20 and so on. Now, you should come to know the least common multiple is 12. Means we have to convert this 3 and 4 into 12. So it will become 5 upon 3. Now 3 4s are 12. So numerator and denominator both should be multiplied by 4. 5 4s are 20. 3 4s are 12. The second fraction we have 2 upon 4. 4 3s are 12. So numerator as well as denominator both should be multiplied by 3. So it will become 2 3 is 6 and 4 3 is 12. Now we have both the fractions 20 upon 12 and 6 upon 12. Now we have to decide which one is the greater. This time we have the equal denominator, means like fractions. And we learn in the first type of the comparison, if we have the like fractions, so in that case which numerator is greater, just see it. 20 and 6. Which one is greater? 20. So we can easily say 20 upon 12 is greater than 6 upon 12. Got it? As we learn in the first comparison. Once again, if we have the unlike fraction, just convert these two into like fractions, like here we did. Then we have to do the comparison. Both the denominator are same. So we have to decide on the basis of numerator. Which numerator is greater, the same fraction should be greater than the next one. So this way we have to do the comparison of the fractions. Now, whenever we have the such kind of the sums, first thing we have to go to the first comparison. Means whether if they are the like fraction, decide according to the numerator. If we have the comparison of the fractions, and in these fractions, if the numerators are equal, go through the denominator wise. In the denominator, which one is smaller, in actual sense that fraction should be greater. And if we have the unlike fractions, means not the neither numerator nor denominator was same. So what we have to do, first we have to do the comparison, converting that into the like fraction, then do the comparison. So same kind of the sums we have in the next problem set number 19. So let's see. Problem set number 19, the question number 1 is given. Write the proper symbol from, here we have the 3 symbol. This one is the symbol of smaller one, this is the symbol of greater one, or this is the symbol of is equal to in the box. means here we have the few fractions and within that we have a box and we have to do the comparison, which one is the greater, which one is the smaller, or both are the equal. So come for the first one, 3 upon 7 3 upon 7. You should easily come to know regarding these two fractions are equal fractions. The value of these two fractions should be same. You are able to see. Come for the next one, second, 3 upon 8 2 upon 8. Here this is the first type of the comparison, like fraction. Both the denominators are same. Now we have to decide according to the numerator. 3 and 2, which one is the greater? 3 means this should be the greater fraction. The third one, 2 upon 11, 10 upon 11. Again we have the denominator same, means like fractions. So we have to decide according to the numerator, 2 and 10. Which one is the greater? 10. So 10 upon 2 is the 10 upon 11 is greater than 2 upon 11. Now come for the fifth. Just wait for the fourth. Here we have the 5 upon 8 and 5 upon 9. This type of the comparison also we learn. Here we are able to see the numerators are same. Now we have to decide regarding the denominator. So whenever we are deciding regarding the denominator, in that time the smaller one is in the real sense is greater. So 8 and 9, which one is the greater? 9. But we have to write opposite of that, 8. So 5 upon 8 is greater than 5 upon 9. Once again, whenever we have the equal numerator and we want to decide regarding the denominator, so which one is the smaller, in the actual sense that is the greater one. 9 and 8, 8 is smaller, but here we have to write the opposite of that, as because 5 upon 8 is greater than 5 upon 9. Now come for the sum number 4. If we have such kinds of the sums, so if you are able to see 5 upon 15, 10 upon 30, is it the 10 of multiple of 5? Yes, 5 to the 10. So if we are converting the 5 into 10, means we are multiplying by 2, it will become 10. And the same time 15 also multiply by 2, it will become 30. Means here we are getting 10 upon 30, and the second fraction already we have 10 upon 30. Means both are having the equal value. So this way we have to do the comparison of the given fractions and decide which one is the greater, which one is the smaller, or which ones are the is equal to. Now on the basis of same, the remaining three sums you should be solved by your own. In the sixth one we have the equal numerator, you should be decide according to the denominator. The same way in the rest two also, you have the equal numerator and you are going to decide regarding the denominator. Now here we have the ninth one, 5 upon 6 and 1 upon 8. Now you are able to see it is like the third type of comparison. Neither numerator are equal nor the denominators. So means we can say these are the unlike fractions and we are going to do the comparison between these two fractions. What we have to do? First we have to convert this fraction into like fraction. So multiple of 5, that is 5, sorry, we have the 6 denominator, multiple of 6, 6, 12, 18, 24, 30 and so on. The second denominator we have 8, multiple of 8, 8, 16, 24, 32 and so on. Once we got the common factor, just stop it. So you are able to see here we have the common multiple 24. Means we are going to convert this 6 and 8 into 24. Let's do it. 5 upon 6. 6 4 ja 24. Same time we have to multiply the numerator also. 5 4 ja 20. 6 4 ja 24. Second, 1 upon 8. We have to convert this 8 into 24, means 8 3 ja. Numerator also multiply by 3. So 1 3 is 3, 8 3 is 24. Yes, do you got it? If you are able to see, now we got the like fractions. Denominators are equal in the both, and we have the numerator 20 and 3. Now we have to decide according to the numerator, which one is the greater, 20 or 3? 20. So we can say 20 upon 24 is greater than 3 upon 24. So we can say 5 upon 6 is greater than 1 upon 8. This way we have to do the comparison of unlike fractions. See one more sum. 5 upon 12 and 1 upon 6. Multiple of 12. 12, 24, 36 and so on. Multiple of 6. 6, 12, 18, 24 and so on. If you are able to see, here we have 12 common multiple as well as 24. But we are talking about the least. If rather than taking 12, if we by mistake took the 24, then also we will get the right answer. But as per according to rules, we are taking the least common multiple. Means we are going to do the conversion of this 12 and 6 into 12. So 5 upon 12, already we have the 12. Let's do it. 1 upon 6. 6 2s are 12. Multiply by the denominator by 12. So numerator also multiply by 12. Sorry, 2. 1 2s are 2. 6 2s are 12. And here we have 5 upon. So first fraction we have 5 upon 12. And second we got 2 upon 12. Now we have to decide according to the numerator, as we got denominator become same. 5 and 2. Which one is the greater? 5. So 5 upon 12 is greater than 1 upon 6. This way we have to decide the unlike fractions are whether they are greater, which one is the greater or the smaller. These lines are optional, whether you should write or don't write, you have to do in the rough work. Directly you should convert into the like fraction and do the comparison and put the proper sign in the box what we have. So this way we have to do the comparison of the given unlike fractions. So this way, first we have to convert the unlike fraction into like fraction. According to numerator, we are going to decide which one is the greater and which one is the smaller. On the basis of same, you have few sums for your homework. Say 11th one, 7 upon 8, 14 upon 16, 4 upon 9, 4 upon 9, 5 upon 18, 1 upon 9, 2 upon 3, 4 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 5 upon 9, 4 upon 11, 1 upon 5. These all are the homework for you all. You should be do this homework, this all sum in your homework, and still if you are getting any kinds of difficulties, you should be ask in your group and complete your homework, submit it in your group. The next concept we will continue in the next video. Thank you so much.